بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين، أما بعد. We're continuing in these short talks, these short sittings and reminders after صلاة العشاء بإذن الله عز وجل. And the writing of the short Risala, Sheikh Abdul Razzaq Ibn Abdul Muhsin Hafidhum Allahu Ta'ala, and that is the Risala or the Kitab Al-Dhikr wa Dua. And so far we have discussed some of the virtues and the excellence and superiority of Al-Dhikr, as well as the command of Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala to remember him much, and the rewards for those who remember Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala much. We mentioned some of the adilla from the Quran and some of the adilla from the ahadith. And then the Shaykh, he goes on into another bab, another chapter, and that is Fadl al-Dua. And all of this is a muqaddima, all of this is an introduction. But he goes into the next bab, and it is Fadl al-Dua. We'll try to take, bi-ithnillahi ta'ala, something from this tonight, briefly. And then the next bab after that is the excellence of Fadl al-Istighfar. The Shaykh brings as his evidences those ayat from the Quran and the hadith of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, beginning with the ayah, the very well-known ayah in Surah Al-Ghafir, ayah 60, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمْ أُدْعُنِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ إن الذين يستكبرون عن عبادتي سيدخلون جهنم داخلين. And this is the statement of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, what is translated and interpreted to mean in the English language. And your Lord has said to make dua to me, to call on me. أستجيب لكم, I will respond, I will answer your supplication. And indeed those who are too arrogant and they have too much pride to call on me, to call on me alone, or to call on me at all, then they are those who will enter Jahannam Dakhirin, they will enter the Jahannam, the hellfire, as those who are humiliated. Allah Ta'ala, he says also in Surah Al-Baqarah, the Shaykh, he brings the ayah, وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي أَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِ إِذَا دَعَانِ فَلْيَسْتَجِيبُوا لِي وَلْيُؤْمِنُوا بِي لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْشُدُونَ. Allah Ta'ala, he says, and when my servants, they ask you about me, then inform them that indeed I am near. And from this verse here, we know that the ulama of tafsir, they mentioned the qissa behind this. Some of them, they mentioned that this verse was revealed because of the companions asking the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Is our Lord Ba'id Fanunadihi? Is he far away so that we need to call out to him with a loud voice? Or is he Qareeb Fanunajihi? Is he near to us so that we can call out to him in a very subtle tone, in a very private discourse? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he revealed this verse here. Also from that verse we see the tenacity of the companions for the fiqh of the religion, for understanding of the religion, of wanting to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and do those particular actions in the best of manners and the most desired of manners, asking the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about this so that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala revealed this verse. And he says that indeed I am near, ujibu da'wat al-da'i idha da'an, and I answer the supplication of every supplicant when he supplicates to me. فَلْيَسْتَجِيبُ لِي, so seek this and respond to that which it is, or seek the response from me and believe in me, that which anticipated from that, what we hope to be the outcome of that, is that they will be from amongst people who are guided. And then the Shaykh, he brings the hadith on the authority of An-Nu'man ibn Bashir, collected by Imam al-Tirmidhi, and that he said that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Al-Dua'u huwa al-ibadah. That the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said that dua, it is ibadah. That dua itself, it is ibadah. And of course, this is the hadith, not the weak hadith, the ad-du'a mukhul ibadah, which is a hadith that is weak, but this hadith is ad-du'a'u huwa al-ibadah. The du'a is ibadah in and of itself. ثم قرأ وقال ربكم ادعوني استجب لكم إن الذين يستكبرون عن عبادتي سيدخلون جهنم داخرين. And then he recited the verse that we just mentioned, and when your Lord has said to call on me, I will respond to the end of the ayah. Looking at this particular hadith here of the Messenger of Allah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam mentioning that du'a is ibadah, we know that du'a is of how many types? As the people of knowledge have mentioned, Zahid. Two. What are they? Du'a al-mas'ala and du'a of ibadah. طيب. What is du'a mas'ala? Something interesting here. What is du'a of mas'ala? This is the obvious one.
Your question?
Yes.
عندما يكون لك طلب لله سبحانه من الله سبحانه.
ها؟
عندك مسألة معينة الله أن الله سبحانه وتعالى يقضيها لك.
على أي طريقة؟ مثل لنا. اضرب لنا مثال.
أي مسأل الله توفيق في حياتنا.
No, asking Allah, just asking Allah in general for anything. Allahumma arhamni, Allahumma kfilni, right? Asking Allah for anything, this is the obvious one. Asking Allah, explicitly mentioning something with your tongue that you are supplicating to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What is du'a of al-ibadah? Dhikrika wa shukri ibadatika. Du'a of ibadah, du'a of al-ibadah, is that when you are doing an action that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with, which we know what ibadah is. It's munjamiun li kulli ma yuhibbuhu Allahu yardah min al-aqwal wal-af'al al-zahir wal-batina. Right? Everything that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala loves and is pleased with from statements and actions is, that an internal or external, is ibadah. So when you go and establish an action of ibadah, even though you're not saying, oh Allah, grant me Jannah, oh Allah, save me from the hellfire, oh Allah, have mercy upon me, oh Allah, reward me, even though you may not actually be saying that, you go and give someone sadaqah fi sabilillah, ibadah. You say, assalamu alaikum rahmatullah, and you smile in the face of your brother, ibadah. You remove something harmful from the road, ibadah. Right? You have intimacy with your wife, ibadah. Sah? Even though you're not asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explicitly, like when you say, Allahumma kfilli, Allahumma arhamni, even though you're not explicitly asking for something, it is though you're asking him for that. When you perform that action for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it is as if you are supplicating to Allah, but you're not necessarily saying something specifically. And of course, many actions of ibadat involve supplications. But in general, just to do something that is pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves and is pleased with, is an action of ibadah, and it is, how do we say, indirectly a du'a. Indirectly a du'a. So, al-du'a huwa al-ibadah. وَعَنْ أَبِي هُرَيْرَةَ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى عَنْهُ أَنَّ النَّبِيِّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ قَالَ لَيْسَ شَيْءٌ أَقْرَمَ عَلَى اللَّهِ مِنَ الدُّعَاءِ. This hadith collected by Imam al-Tirmidhi and Ibn Majah. On the authority of Abi Hurairah رَضِيَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى عَنْهُ, he said that there is nothing more honorable to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than الدُّعَاء. Than الدُّعَاء. And this is why I don't like using the electronic devices for classes. And then there's another hadith on the authority of Abi Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala anhu also, in which he said, قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ مَنْ لَمْ يَدْعُ اللَّهَ سُبْحَانَهُ غَضِبَ عَلَيْهِ. Collected by Imam al-Tirmidhi and Ibn Majah. That the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said that whoever does not supplicate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala become angry with this individual. Whoever does not call on Allah, who does not ask Allah, who does not supplicate to Allah, opposite of the creation, as much as you ask the creation, they what happened? They become angry with you. When you continue to ask a person for something, he becomes angry with you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala becomes angry when you don't ask him. لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٍ لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٍ. Also from the حديث عن ذوري أبي هريرة رضي الله تعالى عنه أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال ينزل ربنا تبارك وتعالى كل ليلة إلى السماء الدنيا حين يبقى ثلث الليل الآخر فيقول من يدعوني فأستجيب له، من يسألني فأؤتيه، من يستغفرني فأغفر له. Collected by Imam Bukhari and Muslim. This hadith in which he mentions that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said that our Lord descends to the every night to the lowest heavens when there only remains a third portion of the night remaining, saying, who is there that is supplicating to me so that I may respond to him? Who is there that is asking me so that I may give him? Who is there that is seeking forgiveness from me so that I may forgive him? This hadith is muttafaqun alayh. So from these ahadith here, these few ahadith we mentioned tonight, bi-ithnillahi azza wa jal, we hope that they are something that will encourage us to increase in our dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us amongst those sincere servants who we call on him and we worship him by way of that which he has legislated. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in.
Muhammad, assalamu alaikum. Oh yeah, I'm just like you.